Designing or checking reinforced concrete beams and columns is quick and easy in GASS. In this video, we will show you a beam design followed by a column design, and then have a quick look at the management tool that lets you manage all your concrete beams and columns in one place. This building model consists of concrete frames with one-way slabs that span between them. Filters have already been defined, and so let's isolate a typical internal frame. The beams have been modeled as T-beams that incorporate the slab. The columns are rectangular. Pattern live loading has been applied in various load cases for loading all spans, alternate spans, adjacent spans, and the central span. Other load cases and combinations have also been defined. The model has already been analyzed, and you can see the effect of the pattern loading on the bending moments and shear forces as we scroll through some of the load cases. Let's start by designing the first floor beam. It's just a matter of selecting its members, right-clicking, and choosing the concrete beam module. It's as simple as that. Of course, if you're not happy with the design, or if you want to fine-tune it a bit, you can go ahead and make changes using the various input controls. Such as the load cases being used, the design priorities, bar settings, bar anchorage, moment redistribution, and so on. Each time you make a change, the design is automatically updated. If you don't want this to happen, you can untick the Auto option and then click the Check or Design buttons whenever you're ready. The panel at the top shows the overall beam in 3D, or 2D. The central panel lets you see envelopes of the bending moments and shear forces. It can also show the elastic, short-term, long-term, and total deflections. The cross-section panel applies to the currently selected zone and is updated whenever you change to another zone. The status line indicates if the beam has passed or failed and includes information about the critical load case, zone, utilization ratio, and governing failure mode. If you want to check a beam rather than designing it, you can just change the reinforcement to your requirements and then see if it passes or fails. A check indicator in the status line shows that it has been checked rather than designed. For safety, whenever you change the reinforcement, it is locked to guard against you inadvertently performing a design and losing your reinforcement changes. Of course, you can unlock it if you really want to revert back to a design. Now let's save the beam and switch to a column design. This time we select a column and then open the Concrete Column module. As with the beam design, that's all there is to it. You can adjust things by changing any of the settings in the side panel and seeing how they affect the design. Or you can switch to check mode by specifying the reinforcement yourself rather than having it determined for you. The column and its cross section are shown in the panels at the top, complete with a full reinforcement specification. Interaction diagrams show the column's axial load versus moment envelope. They also include the load case points so that you can compare the design actions with the column's capacity at a glance. Loads that fall within the red curve pass and those that fall outside fail. You can even hover over any part of the diagram to see its underlying values. The pass-fail status is also reflected in the status line at the bottom. Both the concrete column and beam design modules let you generate fully detailed drawings of the longitudinal sections and cross-sections in DXF or DWG formats that you can then import into your CAD system. You can also generate concise or more detailed reports. Now let's open the Concrete Management tool. The table at the bottom shows the beam and column we just created, together with some others that were created previously. You can click or scroll through them to see their details, or double-click one to open it in the Design Editor and make further changes as required. The colored blocks on the left indicate whether members have passed or failed or have no results. And the blocks in the next column containing D's or C's indicate whether members have been designed or checked. One of the most useful things about the management tool is that you can redesign or recheck all your beams and columns in batch mode rather than having to open and process each one separately. This is very handy if you've made changes to the model or have reanalyzed it. Preferences let you control your designs more effectively and specify default settings for new beams and columns. Finally, various types of summary or detailed reports can be viewed or printed from the management tool. This has been an overview of the Reinforced Concrete Beam and Column Design modules in GASS. For a more in-depth look, you should view their full videos.